Hello everyone, in this video we are going to explore the best VPN for China in my experience. Why this video? Because first, it's my fourth year in China and my major is computer science, so you can say that I know what I am talking about. Second, this is my experience, I'm not sponsored or anything like that, so I will be sharing my experience only. And you are welcome to explore other videos and blogs. If you are going to search in Google, you are going to see the many options. You can see that this VPN is actually useful, so we list it up. You can see these, like I clicked this link, there are many VPNs, this link many VPNs, this link many VPNs. So the question is that which one is best, and even on YouTube there are many videos, related videos. But I don't know if these people are going living in China or what, but their name tell that they are tech vloggers or something, so I'm not sure they are living here or not. But some other videos, this guy maybe is going to guide you or something, you can explore them if you want. So now let's talk about these VPNs which we were talking. So my point is that although these VPN are good organization, good and even big organization, maybe millions of dollar organizations like ExpressVPN and NordVPN, but at the same time, you know that VPNs are blocked in China. It's not allowed in China. It's even illegal in China. So in that case, these VPNs are banned by the government. So people or tech people of the tech, the government officials know these about these VPNs, and they try to block it. And obviously these VPNs are trying to overpass or overcome the that solution or that problem. So my view is that these VPNs are not actually really good idea, and also these VPN are expensive. VPN which I said, I know some people are using Astral and they say that it is good one, but I'm not sure that because I have not used. Now let's come to the point that which VPN I am using. So first let me show you this screen. This one is Clash for Windows. So many people use this Clash for Windows. It's actually a software. In that software you need to install these profiles. So these profiles are actually paid profiles you need to buy from some website. So if you have this profile, then you can get something like these proxies. You can say that global rule, and you can also test the speed. Okay, sometimes even it's even less, maybe 200 or something millisecond, and you can see that 200 something millisecond. So sometimes it is good, sometimes some servers are not working. So this is how it works. But you need to buy these profile. Now question is that how to buy these profile. These are the three. First one, when I came to China, I started using this guy service. Need to log in. Okay, and in this I still have 150 RMB, you can see, but they are not returning my 150, and currently I am not using their service. You can log in it with like this worldnode.top, or and then you can log in here, or then after login you can see this store option, and these are their prices. You can see that they have like 100 GB data and per month, actually one device, and 200 yuan per year, which in my opinion it is expensive. That's why I did not use this further, because before when I first year I bought it was like 150 RMB something. Second service, if you want to buy from them, you can go and buy. I am going to post my link here, maybe you can use that if you want. Second one is this Glad OS, which currently I am using, which I show you here. I have shown you here. So this is the this Glad OS. You can log in with GladOS.rocks, but some pros and cons. Currently I have two packages of it. Let me show you the different. This is the basic package. Basic package, you can see that 2.21 US dollar per month, okay, for the yearly plan. So if you want to buy, maybe you can test it. And these are their facilities, that three devices, 200 GB. Remember that previous one have 100 GB and 100 Mbps speed. And here if you compare with the Pro, it's 6 devices, 500 GB, 200 Mbps. And then they support the further like game boosting, WireGuard, OpenWRT routers and search clients. I did not use these facilities. Mostly I use it for computer, only for computer, not some other kind of things. I forgot to tell you that I am using this for Windows and for the Android. And I also have shared with another friend. That friend is using with the Apple mobile iPhone. So these are the services. If you want to maybe buy this one, you can also buy this one. And third one, this moji.me, you can log in here. Here they have different kind of plans, and it's actually they are selling the traffic. You can see that 130 GB in 14 RMB, 420, 42 and for so on so forth. But they don't have any devices limit, they don't have any expiration time, and they don't have any limit on the network speed as compared to these guys which have the network speed limit. So it's up to you if you want to buy from any of these three. I will post the link in the description. If you want to buy these any of three, you can buy. But in my experience, in my opinion, these clash based services are better as compared to those famous services like which we have previously seen here, like these services. If I have to choose it, I would prefer using this service which I am currently using. For iPhone, if you want me to make a tutorial that how to use this, how to install it and everything, I will make another video. You can comment and ask, because I'm not sure that how much views I am going to get on this video. So I hope this video will be useful for someone. Okay, bye bye.